2K Sports pregame show.
Sports. I'm glad you could join us on this exciting Friday night matchup. Along with Greg Anthony and Clark Kellogg, this is Kevin Harlan. Glad to have you with us. We're broadcasting live from Boston, the home of the Celtics. And, of course, Kirk Heinrich. Even with him gone, they've shaken it off quickly and have really come together as a team.
Kevin, I thought he was really an important player for them, undervalued and not given the credit he deserved. That's not to say the trade was a mistake. I think they'll miss him more than you might expect.
You know, chemistry-wise, I agree with you, Clark, because he was a glue guy. You know, he's a guy that kind of held things together for them in a few areas, and so not having him around might take some getting used to.
All right, let's set the floor, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. So the Bulls five right now. At the four, it's Gasol with Noah at the five. Butler teamed with Dunleavy on the perimeter, and it's Rose in at the one. One thing about David Lee, he's a proven scorer and rebounder. Clark, health, though, has been a concern.
It has been. Very durable early in his career, Kevin, but of late we've seen hamstring issues, back issues, and torn hip flexors, and that's taken a toll on him for sure.
Bradley with the ball. Gasol covering. Bradley kicks to Olynyk. Lee, a screen on Butler. Smart, wide open, he fires. The rebound by Noah.
Guys, for David Lee, when healthy, he can absolutely fill it up. I mean, he's a terrific offensive player, can score over both shoulders, a really solid passer, and of course, a volume rebound.
And Boston has possession after the Bulls pick up two. Smart passes to Olynyk. Boston, no good that time either.
I didn't see that miss coming. I mean, he's usually been money from that range.
Out left to the wing. Dunleavy for three. Yes, and it's Rose with the assist that time. Dunleavy's got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
And David Lee reworking to improve his mid-range jumper going into last season. When he's hitting that shot, guys, he's almost impossible to defend. And you know, it took him a while to get going, but they finally connected now on their fourth shot of the game.
Dishes it to Noah. Olynyk with the steal. And a fast break now for the Celtics. Smart leading the charge.
And that steal paid instant dividend.
No wasted time or motion getting out on that fast break.
Butler dishes to Rose. And he gets it to go.
Defensively, that possession better not start a trend because they just handed him 2 points.
The Celtics have gone 2 of 5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. There's a screen. Smart kicks to Bradley. A three-pointer off the mark. Well, it was the Boston Celtics, their last game, a loss to the Raptors in Toronto.
And I really felt in watching that game that they needed to abandon the three-point shot. It wasn't there. The percentage was horrific, but yet they continue to try and knock them down.
And I really think that's what did them in. I mean, sometimes it's just not there for you on the perimeter. You can't try to shoot yourself out of a bad shooting night from outside.
Here's Olynyk. Jimmy Butler making his last shot. Clock at six. Lee kicks to Bradley. Again, the Celtics good for two. For Chicago, they've gone 4 of 4 to start. So a nice offensive rhythm to start here. Here's Gasol, and it is flushed down with a nice jam.
Good ball movement. He put that pass in the ideal spot, right where it needed to be.
Celtics trail by four. Got a piece of it. Out of bounds, Celtics ball as Boston keeps possession. Let's send it out to DB, who caught up with head coach Brad Stevens. Doris?
I asked asked him what he'd most like to see from his team today, and he told me, we'd really like to keep Pau Gasol under wraps in this one. He went on to explain that Gasol can take over games with his efficiency on the offensive end, and the key to their win will be getting a hand in his face every time. Guys?
Thanks a lot, Doris. And the basket by Olynyk. Olynyk's got his first points in this one.
Really, really good at recognizing the gaps and getting the ball to the rim.
Noah, the pass to Gasol. Good, and a nice assist from Noah.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's four straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
And good on the basket. Book it.
And off to a strong start offensively. He's got a nice touch.
Butler kicks it to Noah. To the middle. Pau Gasol again. Gasol's got six.
An excellent display of passing out there, fellas. I mean, eight of their last 10 points have been assisted on.
And they just keep finding the open man.
Now here's Lee. He has five. And he dunks it after the pick frees him up.
And did you see the screen that was set for him? I mean, that was how he got to the hoop.
It was the classic screen play. It won't show up in the box score, but that screen deserves an assist.
Absolutely, Kevin. I mean, that took the defender right out of the play.
Goes up again. Rose up on top. He's coming off a 13-point game against Golden State.
And also, his assist total tells you about the job he did of keeping his head up and keeping his teammates involved.
They set the pick. Lee is screen on Rose. Bradley can't get it to go. For Chicago, they've gotten seven of their first 10 attempts to fall so far. Excellent pace to their offense. Derrick Rose has certainly piled up the awards for such a young player, starting with Rookie of the Year, 111 first-place votes to only five for the runner-up. We know about his MVP, and that just shines out so brightly for him.
And how about he and Michael Jordan, the only MVPs in Chicago Bulls history?
Here's what Boston's going with right now. Tyler Zeller's checked in for Olynyk. Sellinger comes in for Lee. Your Rebco's checked in for Bradley. And it's Turner in for Smart. They get it back. Zeller. And he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
And great effort on the boards. And what a mean.
Yeah.
That was, Kevin. I mean, you just will not see him ever quit on a play.
That guy is a handful. You've got to have a body on him, Clark, at all times.
And you know what? Sometimes that's not even enough. He'll go around, over, or through you to get to the pump. You know, looking back to Rose's MVP award, his stats were on another planet that year. He was only the third player to record 2,000 points and 600 assists in a single season since 1973. The other two, LeBron James and Michael Jordan.
Now here's Turner. He averages a bit over 6 points a game. And so it looks like the Celtics will retain possession here. Left here in the opening quarter. Here's your Repco. The shot is off. Good D by Sanders.
You know, in talking about D Rose, I don't think the individual awards mean much to him. He's about trying to help his team win championships. And that's the kind of mindset he has to continue to display.
Stolen by Rose. Here's Mirotić, and he caught that pass in full stride on his way to the big slam.
And that's how you make a steal count. Turn it into a quick slam at the other end.
It was really a case. It looked like Greg Anthony right there, if I can say so. It was really a case of a great defensive play triggering some instant offense.
Yeah, I remember T.A. as an irritant. This guy, much like Greg, creating havoc out there. That's a clean look they gave him there, fellas, and he drains those.
6 second difference between shot and game clock. Gibson the screen. Sanders in the post. He's covered by Zeller. That's good. 8 points for Rose.
Boy, they are passing the ball very crisply right now.
They really are, and their last three buckets have come by way of an assist.
Fades away. Lands soft on the front of the rim and drops. Here's Miritich. He hits the shot at the very last second.
Goodness. The pressure on him in those circumstances was massive.
And welcome back. It's been all one-sided so far through the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And a moment to look at the scoring approach. In terms of where the points are coming from for Chicago.
They've been making some really nice passes out there. Excellent passing. That could set the tone for the rest of the game.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
Bradley and Turner filling out the perimeter. Jared Sullinger is out there with Amir Johnson. And it's Smart in at the point guard position. That's the Boston Five. Shot from 12. Count that one. The Bulls' lead has been cut down now to just 10 on the basket from Sullinger. Chicago's gone 3-of-3 from three-point land here tonight. Here's Sanders. Good D by Sullinger.
And you can see the defenders afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Johnson sends the screen for Brent. No luck. And Chicago will go the other way with the ball. They come in fresh off a win against the Warriors.
And the way they attacked the basket in that game was unreal. I mean, after a while, the defenders seem to just wave the white flag.
Yeah, like you said, I mean, that's what will happen when a team continues to attack the basket and come away with layups. The defense tends to get demoralized and deflated.
A second chance effort and two free throws coming up as he misses that one, drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there. Celtics have shot two free throws and they're 1-2 so far.
Only shooting 71 really on the season, so there is plenty of room for improvement.
You know, I know that's an aspect they've been trying to address as a team. I mean, they've got to get those free throw numbers up and improve.
Olenek, he's checked in for Boston. Chicago also making some changes. Joakim Noah is checked in for Sanders. And Pau Gasol is subbed in for Taj Gibson.
Another pass put right into the shooter's pocket, right in the shooting pocket for a terrific assist. They've done a lot of that today.
And it's something we haven't seen much of at the opposite end of the floor.
We're about a minute and a half into the second quarter now. Now here's Smart. Brooks covering. Johnson the screen. And there's the foul. It'll go on Aaron Brooks. That's his first foul. Bradley kicks to Turner. Terrific design on the pick look. He lays it in. Turner's got his second basket of the game.
Boy, that was a rugged screen set there, fellas, and the defense didn't even try to go through that one.
And how thrilled must have Evan Turner been last season to get a second chance, part with the boost in minutes, confidence, coaching staff. His game almost just changed overnight.
Yeah, he's a guy who needs the basketball. He's such a good, solid playmaker and has excellent size. Never had a chance in Indiana to really handle the ball and play to his strengths because of Paul George and Lance Stephenson, but he found a nice niche in Boston.
Well, you know what he can do after watching him for so many years with the Buckeyes.
Yeah, he's terrific. Good basketball IQ, too.
Gasol kicks the button. It's stolen by Bradley. And pushing it up, here's Boston. It's tipped. In transition, here come the Bulls. Here's Gasol. Rebounded by the Celtics. Victory eluded them last time in Chicago when they faced the Bulls.
Yeah, their defense got sliced and diced in that game. They just weren't closing down on perimeter shooters, not nearly quick enough. And then they gave up their fair share of those point-blank shots on the interior as well.
Something was clearly amiss for them, Greg. I mean, to let an opponent shoot that high a percentage, you got to take a real long look in the mirror after a game like that.
David Lee checked in for Johnson. Mike Dunleavy, who's checked in for the Bulls. Now here's Smart. Brooks covering. Smart gets to Lee. The runner, and Gasol sends it back. Here's Butler. Back to Brooks. Shoots the three. Good, and a nice assist from Noah. Noah's got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. Celtics trail by 10. Astrolinic. The 9-foot shot. And it's Gasol with the rebound. Gasol's got his third rebound tonight. Here's Brooks. Gasol against Lee. And here's Brooks from outside. The rebound by Turner. Austin's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. Here's Lee. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Lee's got 9.
The number of points they've scored in the paint already today is pretty eye-opening.
It really is, Clark. The defenders need to do a better job of closing those lanes to the hoop.
Celtics have gotten just over 50% of their shots to drop here in the second quarter. They're 5-for-9. Gasol kicks the butt. From down in the low post, it goes.
Yes, sir.
Butler's got his third basket of the night.
And that's what you want to see. Good, fundamental, sound basketball with the bounce pass.
And the thing with Kelly Olynyk, he does some stuff that really helps you. And some also that will hurt. I mean, he's highly skilled. He's got the deep range, textbook positioning in terms of the post. A lot of tricky moves down there. Yet he has a hard time being effective against great athletes, which the NBA is filled with. So he's going to have to evolve as a basketball player if he wants to be effective.
That's good. And 11 points for David Lee.
I mean, even he was surprised to be that open.
To the wing on the left. Here's Dunleavy. And the wing jumper offline. Going back to Kelly Olynyk. As a coach, you have to identify the matchups where he can be effective, because Clark is against explosive long limb guys. They'll take advantage of him.
Yeah, they will. But in the right matchup, he's effective. He can help. He makes 35% of his threes. Has done that for the last 2 years. And I think he gives you some toughness and rebounding as well. I like him as a second unit player. Derrick Rose possesses a great skill set. Ball handling, passing, and understanding of how to score. First rookie to ever win the All-Star Weekend Skills Challenge.
Getting back to Rose, it's his extraordinary handle that allows him to get anywhere on the floor. Such confidence in the way he dribbles and drives, whether it's getting up in a position to set up a teammate, take it himself. He's the one very best at controlling that ball.
It's a great point. I mean, guys like D. Rose, Chris Paul, Steph Curry, Kyrie, they all have maximized that skill. I mean, the thing that separates him and puts him in that Russell Westbrook category is the pure physical strength when healthy he's able to play with.
Now here's Crowder. D right on him. On the wing, Turner. And he sinks the shot coming off the strong pick. Turner's got 4 points in the quarter.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you've got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
That's a 2 from Butler. It's good. This time, the assist from Rose. Rose has got 4 assists now tonight.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
Yeah, and it's really fun to see that kind of unselfishness. Really hard not to appreciate all the assists they've racked up.
Here's Crowder. Can't convert after the good screen.
Hey, they got the shot they wanted off of that pick, but it just doesn't fall.
Yeah, it didn't go down, but you'll take that shot every single time, Greg. That's good offense.
7-second difference, shot and game clock. And it's Rose missing.
Not really sure what he was thinking about on that shot. That is not high IQ basketball.
Not at all. I mean, he shouldn't even have considered taking that shot. Just a poor, poor choice there.
Kicks it to Sullinger. Fade away. And the rejection by Sanders. That'll do it.
Thanks, Kevin.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Welcome back, folks. An outstanding first quarter for Derrick Rose. He had 10 points, 4. And that'll do it for now as we...
And as we begin the second half, first half wasn't even close, guys. And we'll see if there is a comeback on our hands or more of the same as we get the third quarter started. We've seen David Lee really having a great game.
he really just broke out the entire arsenal of post moves there in that first half.
And I think he might even have a few more tricks up his sleeve. I mean, he'll break them out as we start heading down the stretch. I'm sure of that.
So for Chicago right now, Rose is the one with Butler as the two. At the four, it's Gasol with Noah at the five. And it's Dunleavy in at the three, the small forward. Chicago leading by 12. Outside Rose. Here's Gasol. And count the basket. He was fouled, and he's going to the line for one more.
Four of their last five makes came off of a high-quality shot inside.
Textbook, really, when you look at how they're playing. They are having their way down low.
Well, the Celtics shooting well, 50% from the floor. The feed to Olynyk. There's the pick. Another shot, and Gasol sends it back. In transition, here come the Bulls. And Rose throws it down.
It doesn't really matter who starts the break with how he runs the floor. He seems to always be the one who finishes it.
Yeah, he is so fun to watch and how he attacks the rim at full speed like that, man. It's something to behold the way that guy gets to the rim.
Here's Smart. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. And here we go. Oh, and the jam by Butler.
And I like how he puts himself in position there to finish on the break.
Yeah, you know, that's what we call seeing and feeling the game. Excellent read of how that play was going to develop and where the ball was going. That's stuff that you oftentimes can't teach, Greg.
And that was Kia bringing you the close-up on the big-time play. Now a timeout called by Boston.
Clearly, he's not pleased with all the looks they've given up on the inside and also to get them to tighten up that defense.
Yeah, and I think he's going to let them know about it. I mean, they're playing some soft interior defense, and you can't win that way. That's a recipe for disaster if you're not going to play with some physicality inside.
Catching up on the changes for Chicago. Heritage comes in for Mike Dunleavy, and Brooks subbed in for Jimmy Butler.
And David Lee missing time early last season with that hamstring injury also opened the door up for Draymond Green to kind of take that starting power forward role. And give Lee credit, though. Didn't sulk, just threw himself into his new role as a super sub.
Bradley dishes to Smart. Screen by Lee. Here's Olynyk. Good, and Smart gets the assist. Smart's got six assists in the game.
Lee with a solid pick that time.
Rose kicks to Brooks. It's deflected. A little over 2.5 minutes off the clock in this final half of play. Olynyk sets a screen for Bradley. Can't capitalize on the good screen. The Bulls leading by 14. Gasol passes to Noah. Rebound by Olynyk.
I'm a fan of anybody who defends that way. I mean, they weren't about to open the door and just allow him to cruise in for a layup.
Over to the wing. Here's Crowder. And another basket for Boston.
Great job of utilizing that screen and finding space to knock down the jumper. Good basketball.
And watching Jay Crowder, he can really beast you up, you know, Greg, and take you out of your game. One of the most physical wings, I think, in the NBA.
And, you know, not the most flexible athlete, but he makes up for that with that strength that you mentioned. It allows him to control the pace. I mean, he's a bumper and a grinder and hitting a big three out of nowhere. So he's what we call a true gamer.
And the Celtics making a change here. Johnson's checked in.
Been a good night so far for Bradley. 9 points, and he's put 1 3-pointer on the board.
You know what, though, Clark? It wouldn't be a bad idea going forward to try to let him do a little more damage from beyond the arc.
This is his first free throw of the game.
Performed well thus far this season with a 78% clip.
Guys, he's slightly fallen off his pace from a year ago at the line, and those points from the stripe have been a little harder to come by. You know, looking at Jay Crowder, he got traded from Dallas to Boston in the Rondo deal last season. Nobody expected all that much from him. All he did was go out and become one of the most valuable players on that team.
Passes it to Olynyk. Outside Bradley.
to the middle. And the shot is good. The Chicago Bulls will get down to 10 points. And thanks to that one from Olynyk.
You know, when you talk about Jay Crowder, there are those that you win because of, and then there are guys like him that you win with. I mean, the guy who's going to take the charge, commit the hard foul, do what others won't, really shows the heart of a champion.
Smart with the ball. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. And Olynyk gets it to go on the assist from Smart. Smart's got assist number 8 here in this one already. Brooks against Bradley. Brooks dishes to Rose. He feeds it to Sanders. The kick out to Rose. Just 5 to shoot for the 3. And the call will be against Joakim Noah. That is his first foul of the game. Jared Sullinger's checked in for Boston. And a change for the Bulls. Taj Gibson's checked in for Noah. In the corner, Crowder with it. Good, and Smart gets the assist. Crowder's got 4 points in the quarter.
And all of a sudden, the shots now falling in bunches. The complexion of this game has completely changed.
Yeah, and that was the only thing that could have brought him back in this game. Everything had to start dropping. And boy, have they gotten on a roll.
And there's the foul. It'll go on Aaron Brooks. That's foul number 2 for him. Some changes for Boston. Zeller, he's checked in for Johnson. Yurebko comes in for Jay Crowder. And it's Turner in for Avery Bradley. Dunleavy's checked in for Chicago. Butler comes in for Brooks. Here's Turner, feeds to Yurebko. And Sullinger kicks to Turner. Sullinger, the screen. The shot by Turner, no good. The Bulls leading by 7. Butler with the steal. Gibson passes to Sanders. Butler against Sullinger. Butler kicks to Dunleavy. Fires the 3. Sullinger with the rebound. Here are the Celtics with the ball. They're on a 16-4 run. To the left side wing. Yurebko drills it from outside. Yurebko's got himself going with the triple, his first basket of the game. Well, Chicago has gotten a success rate of just over 50% from 3-point tonight. 4 of 7 shooting. Rose goes in, fires it up, and the shot falls short this time.
Well, I think the defense got lucky right there. I mean, he's going to make a lot more of those than he misses when he's got that much room.
I mean, that's a tough break for the D. I mean, he took the hit and drew the whistle.
Yeah, but he was late to get there, Greg, so the referee couldn't give him a free pass on that one.
And he sinks the 2nd.
And Evan Turner's one of those guys, he just gives you a little bit of everything. I mean, he can play multiple positions, handles the ball, he can pass it, shoot it. Kind of a Swiss Army jackknife who uses multiple tools to his advantage.
And the foul on Derrick Rose. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line.
And you know, guys, Taj Gibson now has 6 full seasons in the NBA, already 30 years old. Seems like just yesterday he was being drafted.
All free throws good from Turner. Getting back to Gibson, he was one of the oldest college freshmen in the country at age 21. Played 3 years at USC. Then he was one of the oldest players in the 2009 draft, even though he declared as a junior.
Yeah, I think the NBA is the only profession where it hurts you to have a lot of experience coming out, you know, because that's one reason why he did drop. I mean, had he been a couple years younger, with his length and athleticism, he very well could have been a top 10 pick. But I tell you what, the Bulls are happy that he wasn't.
And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2. It's on Jimmy Butler. Celtics have hit 6 free throws in 10 attempts. Jared Sullinger. And he knocks down the 1st one. That one is no good. Here's Zeller, and there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. They get Pau Gasol. The Celtics have made a little more than half their free throws today, 7 of 12.
Tyler Zeller.
And the 1st one at the line is good. He hits one and misses one, each at the line. Sullinger with the bucket.
You've got to give them a lot
lot of credit for just battling back into this game.
Extremely impressive was the rally they made. I mean, we'll see how much their comeback.
We welcome you back to what has been a good one here as we get into the fourth quarter. The Celtics with the lead. Smart and Bradley the guards. Jay Crowder out there with David Lee, and it's Olynyk in at the five. That's who's in the game for the Celtics. And Bradley gets it to go on the assist by Lee. And that's 13 points for Avery Bradley. Chicago has gotten a success rate of just over 50% from three-point tonight. 4 of 7 shooting. Gasol dishes to Mirotic. Outside Rose. Butler on the wing. Six to shoot. Rose kicks it to Noah. Olynyk with the steal. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. And the foul on Derrick Rose. That's foul number two for him. And stolen by Butler.
You know, that turnover right there isn't typical of the performance he's turned in today. In fact, that's his only turnover of the game. He's done a really good job taking care of the ball.
And the offense has just operated really smoothly here in the open floor.
Yeah, and for them to reduce the lead, they should keep the pace brisk. I mean, that's how they've generated the highest quality shots.
Lee against Gasol. To the inside, Bradley. Noah with the block. And here we go, the Bulls fast break. Nice spin off the left rim and in. And that's now 10 points for Nikola Mirotic. And breaking down some numbers here, the hustle stats for the Bulls.
Their defense has been outstanding, closing out on shots and blocking a few as well.
They haven't wasted time getting the ball up the court tonight either, and it's resulted in a lot of fast break points.
Chicago leading. Crowder with the steal. Takes the three. Chicago grabs the miss. Gasol's got his fifth rebound right now in the game. Let's it go with a three. And that's good for Derrick Rose for three. And the Bulls lead by four.
Man, that is not an easy shot right there. I mean, he had to get it off over a much taller defender.
Yeah, he needed to add just a little more loft on that one because of the size mismatch. And did it perfect.
A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Hi, guys. Over that break, I was able to catch the message Brad Stevens was giving to his team. He told his team to keep looking for three-point opportunities, saying their perimeter defense isn't doing a good job getting out on our shooters. So let's keep firing away until they decide to guard us.
Well, you talk about clutch plays defensively and offensively. We saw both right there.
And the gap's narrowing right now. Every second from here on out counts. Neither team can afford to make mistakes. You gotta manage the clock and play smart.
Butler on the wing. Noah the screen. Butler passes to Mirotic. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. Boston trailing. Bradley up top. It's rebounded by Noah. Noah's got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. Rose with the ball. Now guarded by Bradley.
Jump ball.
And so it's Boston with it. The Celtics have gone 2 of 7 from the field in what's been a cold start to the fourth quarter for them. Lee, good, and Smart gets the assist. Lee's got the game tied up here for the Celtics.
That's some grit and determination in the post. Essential qualities to have late in a close game.
Exactly. This is the time to attack on the interior and convert those easy opportunities.
Smart dishes to Olynyk. No good on the three. Chicago's gone 5 of 9 when they put up a three-point shot tonight. Here's Butler. Cannot hit. Now Boston takes it the other way. After this one, they're off to Philadelphia to take on the 76ers. That'll be the first half of a two-game trip. Smart kicks to lead. There's the pick. Four on the clock. Bradley, no one around him. But they recover. And out of bounds it is. Last touch by Miritich. Sanders checked in for Chicago. Dunleavy comes in for Miritich. Here's Bradley. Rebound by the Bulls. Butler's got his third rebound on the night.
He's been wayward and just off on about everything he's put up in this period.
Offensive rebound. The kick out to Rose. Outside Butler. And another shot. And right through it goes. And the Bulls lead by four.
His shooting has been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons they're up in this game.
Now here's Smart. He's covered by Rose. Here's Bradley. Good, and Smart gets the assist. 16 points for Avery Bradley.
First three of the half, second of the game. Can he heat up?
That's a two from Butler. Lee with the steal. Here's Smart in the corner. Crowder with it to take the lead. Rebound by Rose. Rose has got his third rebound tonight. Near the three-point line, it's Dunleavy. The rebound by the Celtics. Lee passes to Smart. 1:58 left in the fourth quarter. Lee is screen on Butler. Smart dishes to Lee. Five to shoot. They double him with Butler. Lets it go. Bradley can't get it to go.
And this quarter, he has clearly been off the mark.
And it's Sanders with the finish.
I don't know that this is the time for that kind of flair. In a close game, the important thing is the 2 points, not the dramatics.
Oh, come on, Clark. He had to go for it, didn't he?
Yeah, perhaps. But hey. He's an athlete, and I can't fault him for that one. Although, if he missed it, I might have.
A minute 34 left to play here in the fourth, and Olenek gets to Smart. They set the pick. He got right to the cup. He's in screen.
Vital basket there. This is just the time and really just the situation when he looks to take over.
Other pass to Gasol. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot two.
Gasol doing all sorts of things. He's got 11 points and a couple of great-looking rejections. So far, two blocks.
Yeah, you know, he's had a great feel for their ball movement down low and for where to be when the shot's going up.
And so he drops them both. It's a three-point game.
Tremendous job at the line, as usual. You can always bank on him in those situations.
Now a timeout called by Boston. They trail by three. 1:11 left here in the fourth quarter. Bradley dishes to Smart. And the official signaled the backcourt violation. Not very careful there.
The turnover total in the first half, only one, but a totally different story here in the second.
Here's Rose, and he gets it to go from the high post. And the Bulls lead by five.
He's got some serious momentum going right now. He's been great all day. Even last game, he was on fire.
The Bulls have gone 7 of 11 from the floor in the final quarter so far. And some solid looks for them. Oh, and the jam by Butler.
Just Mr. Reliable again here today, Kevin. I mean, they need his points, and he's producing.
Smart kick still in it. Rebound by Rose. So here is Chicago. That's a two from Butler. Rebound by Olynyk.
You know what? You just cannot get much better of a look than that.
Exactly. I mean, no way you expect him to miss that shot.
They set the pick. They double him with Butler. Here's Bradley. They get the rebound. Guys, they can just sit on the ball here if they want to.
Sure can, because they've earned the win.
Rose kicks to Sanders. Yes, and it's Rose with the assist that time.
Derrick Rose. Celtics call timeout.
Time called here. The Celtics decide to talk it over. They're down by 9. 7 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
And look, this one's out of reach. I don't know what they're thinking with this timeout.
Neither do I. I mean, maybe they're going over their plan for after the game. Who knows? But let's just get out of here.
Pick off in midair. And so it's Chicago winning this one. They seem to relish their role as the bad guy here tonight.
You know, Kevin.
Well, a nice win for you.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Welcome back, everybody. Ernie Johnson here. Derrick Rose. He was a powerful offensive weapon tonight, scoring a double-double with points and assists. And that was the catalyst for this victory. What'd you think, Shaq?
He was completely in sync with the whole team tonight. And you can see that in the assist numbers, which were spectacular, I might add. It's hard to imagine him having a better night passing the basketball. Man.
His field goal percentage was excellent, up over 60%. This was a player in total control of his game. He didn't try to do too much. He didn't get reckless, just took what the defense gave him.
And that'll do it for our